So obviously I have been building a little home arcade in my basement because I'm really a giant child who just has a little bit of money now to spend. I've added in a lot of arcade one-ups. I have an iArcade in there. I have a skee ball table, an air hockey table, cool little fancy lighting, an MVSX thing, all sorts of fun stuff in there. And I even hung up a TV on the wall recently. But there was one thing that was kind of missing from an arcade because, I mean, it's pretty much in every sort of arcade. And that's a pinball machine. Now, for as much as I know about video games, that's as little as I know about pinball. I really don't know anything about it. I don't know what the best tables are, who the man. I know there's like Williams and Gottlieb and companies like that. I'm probably saying their names wrong, but I don't know anything about pinball because it never was something that I really checked out. I was always playing video games, but it felt like it would make sense to include a pinball table. Now, as far as virtual pinball is concerned, there's a lot of companies out there doing this sort of stuff. I know Arcade 1-Up has a line of pinball machines with like Marvel and Star Wars, and it's like, that's cool, but you only get a couple tables. I don't really care all that much about Marvel or Star Wars enough to have a dedicated machine to it. And then there's another company, a longtime nemesis, someone that I've talked about horribly on this channel before, and that is AT Games. Now, AT Games is, of course, the company behind things like the old Sega Genesis plug-and-play machines that were just absolutely terrible. There was rumors that AT Games was actually going to be working on the Sega Genesis Mini, so much, in fact, that people were making videos on it, so much, in fact, that Sega came out and said, hey, we're not working with AT Games anymore. We're going to be doing this in-house. So AT Games is a company that, I don't know, I guess it kind of has a little bit of stank on it, but they hit me up in an email, and it was like, I don't know. Do I want to do this? Do I want to entertain AT Games again? But I am the kind of person who understands that companies can change. People can become better. Companies can become better. And it seemed like a lot of people that had the AT Games Legends pinball machine actually enjoyed it. So I thought to myself, you know what? Let's meet my old friend. We meet again, Mr. AT Games. And let's see what the AT Games Legends pinball is all about. They sent me the machine to check out, and that's what we're going to talk about in today's video. The positives, the negatives of it, and whether or not this is something that you should think about adding into your collection. So first things first, I want to say that this was extremely easy to assemble. It comes in a couple different parts, but really it's just three main parts. You have the top part, which is like the back display, and it also has two speakers built into it. You of course have the pinball table itself, and then you have legs. You simply attach the legs to the pinball table, you flip it over, then it stands upright, and then you attach the back marquee part. Like, it took me literally 15 minutes, and I'm an absolute idiot when it comes to things like, I burned myself cooking a pizza and I have to wear a band-aid because I was at the gas station and evidently the scab came off and I was bleeding blood all over the place. I don't know. It was a bad scene. But I will say it was very easy to assemble this. As far as how it looks visually, I think it looks pretty good. Obviously, it has a lot of inspiration from various pinball tables that are available on this machine. I don't really know many of these. I do know Gottlieb's Haunted House. You know, that's kind of like a standard when it comes to, you know, pinball tables as far as what pinball tables people like. So I like the aesthetic of it. It's got a lot of buttons on there. Some of them will do tilt mode, so you can sort of shake the machine to move your ball around. Of course, you have your flipper buttons. You have stuff in the front as well to help you navigate. And then you have a top part that has a little D-pad on it. And that's sort of how you go through the menu system. You can actually swap this out for a control panel to play like arcade games on there. They did send me the arcade panel to check out, but I kind of just wanted to review this stock without any of the extra bells and whistles on it. So that's what we're gonna do into this video, but I do wanna check it out in the future. So as far as the system itself is concerned, you have the two speakers at the top, you have two speakers around the trigger buttons on there, and then you have this screen. And I must say, this screen is very impressive. I believe it's 32 inches vertically, and it just looks absolutely gorgeous. Like, there's not really a bad viewing angle on it. You can adjust things like when you want the pinball table setting to be at, like a daytime or an afternoon or a nighttime, so it kind of messes with the lights a little bit on it. But I absolutely love this screen. It's crystal clear, very crisp, very, very impressive, which I'm not used to that with AT Games. I'm used to bottom of the barrel crap. And this is actually really good as far as screen quality is concerned, which is very important because we're playing virtual pinball. Now, what is virtual pinball? I don't really know. It's just like pinball tables that are done virtually, and they give you the sense of playing it on an actual pinball machine. Pinball machines are heavy. Pinball machines are expensive. I don't want to mess around with that. I want to mess around with something simple and easy to get into. As far as the games are concerned, there's over 20 games, or I guess I should say 20 boards, that come pre-installed on this machine. And some of these are really fun. You know, they're more classic-based pinball games, like the aforementioned Haunted House and games of that nature. But I did find a lot of fun with these because I'm not really familiar with them. So when it comes to something I'm not familiar with, I feel like variety is the spice of life, because that's what makes things really exciting for me, and that's what makes me want to check out other tables on the machine. Now, besides the stock tables that come on the machine, you can actually buy more packs that actually give you more tables. Now, the company did say that they're working with some heavy hitters, so you might be seeing some bigger stuff come along very soon, but I was really impressed with the Taito pack that is available on this, because it's basically taking classic Taito games and making them into pinball tables. The Space Invaders one is by far my favorite, because you have these Space Invader creatures that are coming along and they're trying to kill you. And so you're hitting them with your ball, you're hitting certain spots on the map, and in order to make attacks come in, you could freeze them, you could turn your ball into like a flaming ball of like destruction and take them out. It's a really fun mechanic, and it's definitely something that you would only see in a virtual pinball thing, but I think it's really cool, and it's a great way to explore some of the more flashy tables on this machine. Now, there's a bunch of different packs you could download, like the aforementioned Taito packs. You can get, I believe it's pronounced Zachariah. I don't know. Zachary, Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus was a wee little man, and a wee little man was he. But there's a lot of different packs that you can add to the table, which I think is really good. When you're actually playing the games, I mean, it feels like pinball. You have your flippers, of course, to use your different flippers on the games themselves. You could do things like tilt the machine via a button, or you can actually tilt the machine by moving the machine itself to really give it that arcade look and feel. So I think playing the actual games of pinball is really satisfying on this machine. And the fact that you get a bunch of different games on here, or boards, I should say, right off of the bat without having to update it or anything, you know, you get 20 plus right out of the box. I think that's very impressive. It's something that really keeps you coming back for more, because you're not going to play all 20 tables in one sitting. You're going to find a table that you like, you're going to try to do things with it, and then you're going to move on to the next thing. There's online leaderboards for all the tables as well, which I think is really cool. You can rack up with other people who own the AT Games pinball machine as well, see how you stack up with them. I stack up terribly. I am like top like 500 at best on some of these tables, even if I have amazing runs. But I think it's really cool, and it's a very diverse machine because of all the different tables that you can have access to. And of course, the fact that you can play actual video games like shoot 'em ups on here. Like I said, I haven't done this myself yet, but I'm going to show some B-roll footage from Michael B, the Game Genie's channel. I'll have a link to his channel in the description box down below. Go show him some love. People are picking on him because he's been wearing a beanie in some of his recent videos, and they say that he's copying me, which it's a hat. Get over it. So go show him some love on the channel. But he actually has the AT Legends pinball machine. He did the controller swap on it, and the games just look really awesome. So I really want to check out shoot 'em up games on this. But it's a very impressive piece of hardware. The fact that you could get this right now, available through AT Games' website, for $750, I mean, compare that to what Arcade 1UP is doing in terms of the price and in terms of how many different tables you get on this machine. The $750 price point machine also includes a bunch of additional tables, so you're getting more than the 20 tables that it comes with without this bundle deal. So I think it's a really good deal. It pretty much retails for around the $700 to $800 mark, depending on where you buy it from. But I mean, really, for the amount of stuff you're getting on here, I think that's a very good price point. Now, as far as some of my complaints are with the machine, I do have two. One of them I feel is a little bit more serious than the other, but we're going to talk about both of them. The first thing is, it's kind of tough to navigate and add stuff to it, I feel. You know, once you get it set up, like, it's pretty decent, but adding in new tables is actually kind of challenging because there's no onboard storage to add in these new tables. You actually have to get a little flash drive. Now, that doesn't cost a lot of money, but setting everything up on the flash drive can be a little bit confusing, I felt. You know, I feel like more advanced people, as far as technology is concerned, will have no problem with it. Like, I really didn't have an issue with it, but figuring out how to do everything, how to redeem the codes after purchasing them through AT Games' website, was a little bit clunky, I felt. I would have liked to have seen it a bit more streamlined. I understand that they, I guess, couldn't put more onboard memory onto the system. And really, flash memory is super cheap, but it is something worth mentioning. There are videos out there to sort of get you help with, you know, setting this up and redeeming your codes. Once you do it one time, it's not really a big deal, but I did feel like the menu system was a bit clunky. The other thing is with the design of the machine itself, because like I said, it has a total of four speakers, two at the top and then two around the trigger handles that you would use for the buttons to hit the balls with the flippers. And I noticed that when the volume is cranked up beyond like 40, you start to notice some rumbling with the actual plastic of the machine. I have a little sound clip here. Didn't really get it as good as I wanted it to, but take a listen to this. So basically what happens is there's like a rumble with the plastic itself because of the base of the machine. Now I did hear that swapping out the control panel for the other control panel does alleviate this, but I actually found an easier way to sort of do it. And that was just by putting the palms of my hands on top of the machine to play it. And that's how I normally play it anyways. I don't just keep my hands at the side hitting the flipper buttons. I keep my hands on top and use them like this. So it was easy for me to adjust to that, and once I figured that out, you know, I was like, oh, okay, well, this is how I'm gonna play it anyways. But if you only play it with your hands on the side, you're gonna notice a lot of rumbling with this. It's definitely more pronounced on some tables, more so than others, but it's definitely something worth mentioning because it can be a bit of a nuisance. Overall, though, I'm thoroughly impressed with this. I didn't think AT Games I thought AT Games was gonna do their little, you know, crappy consoles that they had, you know, the Sega Genesis flashbacks and shit like that, and then just go into obscurity because everyone made fun of them. But this is a company that took negative feedback, said, you know what, we're screwing up here. We need to do something different. We need to go down a different path, and we need to try to do something different. And they went with that mindset, and they've actually succeeded. They've made a quality product that if you're a pinball connoisseur, like, yeah, you'd probably have like three pinball tables in your house. But if you're an average Joe who just wants to play some pinball games on this, it's super fun. It's easy to set up. Once you get through all the menu navigation and stuff, you're right into the games, and then you're having fun. The screen itself is absolutely beautiful. The games themselves are very responsive. I've had no issues with that. You could do all sorts of things with this machine as well. Like I mentioned, you could play actual video games on this machine. You can actually import boards from like your PC and set up your PC and put whatever you want on it. Like, there's a lot of crazy things you could do with this, but I, of course, am a technical idiot, so I'm not doing stuff like that. But people like Michael B. the Game Genie, people like Cool Toy, they've actually done a lot of cool things with their AT Games Legends pinball machine, and they've really made it very unique, and just the amount of stuff you could do on it is very impressive. So if you're in the market for a pinball machine and you're not like a diehard Star Wars or Marvel person, you just kind of want the spice, the variety of different tables, I think the AT Games Legends pinball machine is worth the money, honestly. It is a little bit disappointing, that rumble that you get, but like I said, I play it with my hands on top of it, so it sort of mutes the rumble. But overall, man, this is really good build quality. It's really fun to play the games, and I'm learning about pinball, and I guess at the end of the day, like, that's an important thing. So those are my thoughts on the AT Games Legends Pinball. Yes, I like the machine. I like an AT Games product. What the hell is happening here, man? What the hell is happening? And as always, guys, let me know what you think of this product in the comment section down below. Have you checked out one of these? If not, do you plan on checking out one of them? Because I think they're super decent, man. I'm really having a lot of fun with it. It's great at parties as well when there's people over, because pinball is something that resonates with everyone. You know, you hit flippers and like you have fun. You see flashing lights, and really that's all I care about, because I guess I'm like a four-year-old with ADD. And as always, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you're new to the channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button, like and share the video as well. And as always, I'll catch you guys on the next video. Later.